My name is Stanislaw Robert Liberta with AV Ultra, and today we're going to be talking about renders and exports in Apple Motion. So in our last lesson, we're taking a look at the 3D layers and the 3D camera. And in this lesson, we're going to be really focusing on exports and playing back as fast as possible. If you'll notice in my scene here, when I play this back, it starts playing really well, and then it starts slowing down quite a bit. There's times that I just want to focus on getting my work out there, and there's other times that I want to focus on fine-tuning my graphic. There's lots of different things that we can do to optimize our playback and our render settings, and then package things up for our final exports. Lastly, we're going to be taking a look at rendering with alpha channels. So when we have lower thirds, we want to be able to export those and have a clear background. Let's go ahead and get started. If you open up your Lesson 10 Exports exercise in the link below, you'll get this project. And it's just a series of different elements that we have in 3D space. This is actually built upon from the last lesson. And you can see that it's having a hard time playing back. Due to the fact that I've got some lights and my cameras and reflections, things will slow down just a little bit. Why don't we go ahead and take a look at our render settings? If I come up to my top right corner, I have my render settings, and you'll notice that I have resolution, quality, light, shadows, reflections, depth of field, and then motion blur, field rendering, and frame blending. Right now, let's talk about the resolution. I'm gonna change this renderer to half. And as soon as I change it to half, you can see that my reflections and my graphics have gotten a little less than ideal. That's okay, because I just want to play this back so we can take a look at it. And right now it's moving just a bit faster, but it's still slowing down quite a bit. So let's come up here one more time and change this to quarter resolution. And again, it is now made at less than ideal again. Now this time it's really kind of chunked up our graphics. You can really see the pixelization. So what it's doing is it's really taking a quarter of the resolution at this point. Take a look at that. And it's still just a bit faster, but overall it's very, very slow. When I'm actually reviewing things, I don't really jump into the resolution settings so much. I will tend to leave this at half or even full, but I really focus on either the quality or light, shadows, reflections. If I change this quality to, let's say, best, full, and I turn on lights, shadows, here's how fast this plays back. I've actually already hit the space bar. But now it is very, very slow because we've got that motion blur and the highest possible playback. So to play this back, if I really want to review this at full resolution and I want to see in real time, if I hold on to Command Option Shift R, I will get a RAM preview. And what this will do is it's basically writing all those frames to my RAM, so that way it will play it back in real time. We pay attention to our RAM preview here. You can see it right around 65 when the camera starts moving. That's when it's having a little bit harder time. And if we come down here to our timeline, we can see how much has been rendered and how much still has to render. So now that I have that pre-render set up, if I play this back, you'll notice that it is playing back in real time. When we're actually using this RAM preview, any changes that we make, so if I move anything in here, that will actually delete this RAM preview. Try not to use that RAM preview until I absolutely need to, or in case something is mission critical as far as layout and composition. Now let's talk about actually exporting using render settings. So to export items out of Motion, we have our share button. You'll notice if I go to File, I don't really have an export, and the only way to get this out is to export using the share. I'm going to skip over the Apple devices, DVD, Blu-ray, email, etc., because the only thing that we're really concerned about is export movie and send to compressor, if you have compressor. If we go to export movie, Command E, we're going to be presented with a new dialog box. And what this is giving us is a small preview of our file, as well as our options. So we have different ways that we can export this. Usually we want to do ProRes 4444 or 422 if we don't have any kind of transparency, or if it's going straight to the web, H.264. And we have have a post-render option, which is open with, so we can say, hey, open it with something else or send it to compressor. And we can include the video or video and audio if we have audio in there. Lastly, we have a duration, which is set to our entire project at this time. And now we have our render setting. You'll notice that we have color and alpha, or we can set it to just color. Because we don't have an alpha channel in here, it doesn't really pay to export things with color plus alpha. And we can set our color space. More often than not, you're going to be using Rec. 709. Your TVs may have HDR televised signals, and those would be in Rec. 2020. Most of the time, though, you're going to be in 709. You can set your render quality, your fields, your motion blur, and your frame blending, same as they are set up in our render. If I set this to use canvas setting, it's going to export exactly the way that my RAM preview exported. However, if I rendering things in draft quality, quarter resolution, and with no lights, shadows, or reflection, and no frame blending, you know, this isn't exactly the way I want it to render out. I want it to play back, but when I render it out, I want it to be at that highest possible quality. If we're previewing our canvas at low quality or without reflections, and we're going to want that in our final exports, that's where we're going to change it from our use canvas settings to say best, turn on our frame blending, turn on our lights, shadows, reflections, and then we'll hit our summary, and that'll give us an idea of how big the file is going to be, frame rate, the resolution, and the codec. You'll notice that I am rendering out in 4444, and that is at 632 megabytes. This is 15 seconds long, so that is a very large file. If I don't have any kind of alpha channels, I'd probably want to push it down to 422. You can see that that changed it down to 282 megabytes. If you are going straight to web and you don't really care too much about the quality, that's where you're going to want to go out through H.264. This movie now is only 42 megabytes. So it's best to render out a highest possible quality that you'll use and then render it down to an H.264. I'm going to go ahead and hit next, and it's going to ask me where I want to save it, and I can just save it on my desktop. If we're going to be exporting a lot of different projects at the same time, that's where you're really going to want compressor. So a lot of times I'm making lower thirds and I might make 20 or 30 of them and I need to send them all out. So instead of waiting for that to render one at a time, I'm going to send it to compressor. If you have compressor installed, it's going to open up and it's going to give you a preview of what you're going to render out. What I like about this is I can set up several different copies at once with different names and different projects, and then start the batch all at one time so I can get on with my work. Additionally, I like to do this when I go for my lunch breaks or end of day. I can let the computer work while I'm working on something else. Here is a preview of our exports. If you're looking for more information on compressor, I have a whole lesson all about using compressor and some of the features you may or may not know about. One last thing I want to talk about here is, what if you want to render something out with a transparency? By a transparency, I mean we want to put this title on top of some other video, but we don't want all this blackness around it here. We want this to be transparent. One, how do I know it's transparent? And two, how do I get that transparency out? If you open up one of your lower thirds that I included free with this training in the description, you can go ahead and open up any one of those, and we'll come up to this top right corner and view our transparency. And if I turn that on, that's going to show us everything that will be transparent if we render with this alpha channel. So if I go to my share and export movie again, I'm going to try exporting this as an H.264. and go to render color and alpha. And even though it says color and alpha, H.264 does not support alpha channels. So we're gonna wanna go ahead and choose ProRes 4444, and we're gonna want our color and alpha and set everything to the best possible setting. I like to go ahead and set these even though they might be in the canvas. And the reason for that is just in case maybe I changed it and I wanna make sure that I get the highest possible quality out of this. So now if I go ahead and I preview this, you'll notice that this is clear in the background. And that's letting me know I have this alpha channel here, and that's the way it's gonna display. That is the basics of exporting out of Apple Motion. Again, you can use compressor or just use Motion in case you're not exporting a lot of different graphics at once. In further lessons, we're going to take a look at how to get this lower third directly into Final Cut. You don't even have to render through Motion at all. We can just bring this whole lower third right into Final Cut, change out our text, and have it render when we render our projects in Final Cut. And my name is Stanislaw Robert Liberta with AV Ultra, and hopefully you found this information useful.